Finland, home to 5 million people and 3 million saunas. Here, warmth isn't just a comfort, it's a culture. But now, the nation that has perfected staying warm in any condition is finding a new way to do it. 50 meters below the streets of Helsinki, a hidden network of tunnels hums with the sound of machinery.
Wow, so where are we?
We are at the Helen heat pump station where we do cooling for the Helsinki data centers. And we take the cool and sell it as a heat for the Helsinki households.
Our guide through this underground maze is Olli Sörkö, CEO of Helen, one of Finland's largest energy providers, and the company turning data center heat into power for the city. Here's how it works. Above ground, data centers, the engines of our digital lives, generate vast amounts of heat as they power everything from AI to streaming video. That heat is captured and piped into Helen's system, where heat pumps raise its temperature even more and send it through the city's district heating network. The same system then returns cooled water back to the data centers. It's a test case for whether our growing digital appetite for energy can be contained.
When you have partners like Equinix and Microsoft and Telia come to you to work with you and partner with Helen, what are they getting exactly in that partnership?
They have a problem with heat and they need to cool down somehow their premises. And our job is to sell heat. So the starting point for discussion is really good. And in the end, we can actually monetize their problem.
Can you just unpack the business part of that?
So in normal case, if you build a, for example, 100 megawatt data center, almost all of that power, practically all of that turns to heat. And they need to get rid of that. They need to invest in heat pumps and all kind of cooling equipment. And if they cooperate with us, they don't have to do that investment. We do it for them. Mm. And we take the heat out. And on top of that, we monetize the excess heat by selling it to our customers. So they save all the cooling cost and it turns to business for us.
So that's a big CapEx outlay
yes.
for you.
Yes.
And CapEx that they don't have to be putting
exactly.
and factoring into their spending plans.
Exactly. The CapEx is needed, but it's done by us and we can get a very good profitable business around that CapEx. So it works for us.
For the local community, the benefits are tangible. Electricity prices that sit below the EU average. Helen's newest partnership is expected to provide warmth for roughly 1,500 homes.
We have been able to increase our profits. At the same time, we have now lowered our prices two times in a row during the last 2 years.
The impressive progress in Helsinki is set against a challenging global backdrop. According to Bloomberg New Energy Finance Research, data centers could consume about 4.4% of global electricity by 2035. If they were a country, they'd rank fourth in electricity use, just behind China, the US, and India. And cooling them already takes up nearly a third of that energy, according to the World Economic Forum.
So this is the bus of the internet and our digital society. So in here, you have what we sometimes refer to as clouds.
Helen manages the heat, but it's Equinix that runs the data centers, more than 270 of them worldwide.
A data center is a part of everything we do digitally.
Regina Donato Dahlström heads their Nordic operations.
So inside of these are servers that are co-located by enterprise customers of Equinix and connectivity, so connections. So all together, we host over 490,000 connections at Equinix.
490,000 connections, and those connections and the work that's being done by these servers creates a lot of heat. You can feel it here in the data center.
It does, it does. Managing the heat is one of the larger parts in operating a data center.
The heat, a reminder that every click, stream, and search has a footprint somewhere in the real world. Managing it is one thing, finding a way to use it sustainably is another.
The way we measure our data centers is very thoroughly with efficiency measures per each square meter. That's on top of mind of any data center operator, because that's money. And it's also a proof point to how good of a data center you have towards your customers. On top of that, we add back to the society in which we invest in infrastructure.
Around the world, the race to build for AI is putting new strain on power grids and sparking a backlash. A Bloomberg analysis of wholesale electricity prices across the US found that electricity now costs as much as 267% more for a single month than it did 5 years ago in areas located near significant data center activity.
When you look at some of your competitors in the data center field, is there ever a sense of frustration or kind of head in your hands moment when you look at the fact that a lot of these data center operators don't seem to be thinking about all the different components that go into it in terms of addressing the energy needs and the sustainability piece?
No, saying that a data center is a data center is like saying a factory is a factory. We do co-location services for enterprises. And I would say that respecting my peers in that part of the data center industry, most of us do care about sustainability.
I guess the critics would say in this rush to build out for AI, that corners are going to be cut when it comes to energy and to sustainability.
And I think in any of the technology waves that we've seen, whether that was IoT or 5G or building out broadband, yes, there are some that get it wrong. There are some that cut corners. There are some that think they've got it right. And then actually the application of the services changes. I think this is no different.
The question now is, can the race to get there first coexist with the desire to get it right? Nowhere is that question more urgent than in the US, home to more than 5,400 data centers, more than all other major economies combined. And most of the electricity to run those data centers still comes from gas and coal, which are also expected to meet much of the country's new power needs over the next decade. Put simply, Finland may offer a glimpse of what's possible. But the real test is whether that model can scale worldwide. It's a question that Noah and Konje has put a lot of time into answering.
The Finnish case is slightly different and across Scandinavia because they have a lot of existing heat networks, and in a lot of other countries, they're not as well developed for heat networks. Having said that, it is still possible to apply some of the learnings. One of the key ones is working with a utility or heat network operator that's keen and supportive.
And Konje pioneered the technology Equinix uses here in Finland and says its applications could be endless.
It's important to point out that the heat export will tend to only work in the right types of climates, so those climates where there is a need for heating. So it won't be applicable, for example, in Dubai or South Africa where it's a very hot climate. So it'll be probably mostly Northern Europe and the northern part of North America as well. And so what tends to be the limiting factor isn't whether you can technically connect in the data centers, but it's usually whether there's a partner who's actually willing to develop a heat network and make the capital investment.
Do you also do it because it's a valuable revenue stream?
It's not a really significant revenue stream compared to the overall data center business. So we're not looking at heat export as a new revenue stream. We're looking because it supports our customer sustainability targets and reporting. It also helps the communities where we operate to cut carbon emissions and also to become more energy independent as well.
And the model hasn't gone unnoticed. Microsoft, one of the world's largest cloud operators, is building its own version, expanding the idea at a massive scale. Ian Doherty leads the company's cloud operations in Europe, the Middle East and Africa.
We're very proud of the project that we're working on in Finland. We're working with Fortum to leverage the waste heat from our data center to decarbonize their local heating system and provide heating to local homes, over 250,000 local homes, in fact.
In the data center race, efficiency is the new currency, and even the world's biggest hyperscalers aren't immune from the pressure to balance growth with sustainability.
Clearly, AI is growing in its use case and diffusion across the globe, and we're seeing that in our own business. And clearly, we need to do more of the same things in sustainability and contract further renewable energies. And so There's a lot of great opportunities that we have ahead of us.
Momentum is building. In Finland, almost 100 data center operators are in discussions with Helen, exploring projects that would feed their own excess heat into the city's energy system.
What do you think your example says about Finland's approach to decarbonizing its economy, but growing at the same time?
Well, I think, and I hope we can show to the rest of the world that you can do the decarbonizing in a profitable way. Because I don't believe it's going to happen if it's forced by state or EU or any other regulatory issues. You have to find a way how to go to CO2 zero so that you can make money with that. Then it starts to happen. And I really hope we can be an example how that is done.
In a moment when our digital lives demand more than ever, Helsinki offers a quiet reminder that progress isn't measured only in speed and scale, but in the balance we keep as the world races ahead.